Hi Aries, it's Tarot Love. This is going to be a weekly tarot reading here the middle of June 2023. And tomorrow is actually summer solstice. So I hope this message finds you well. The moon in Cancer, for those of us, for example, with Venus in Cancer, feeling pretty good about it. Or extremely not. So this probably depends on the money situation. Even for those of you dealing with those types of people, Aries, where this week's energy is affecting them, you will benefit. That's what I see astrologically. So you will most likely benefit from this. And thank you, Spirit. Find ease and comfort to connect with other people here at the end of June. So call on Spirit. Please remember to take what resonates, or leave the rest behind. In general, what does Aries need to know or see this week? Thank you. Get the Knight Swords in reverse. So not coming forward with an idea, not telling people what we think. This is holding back. This is something like that already happening today, kids. So I see the 2-1-1. It's about a fresh start. Current energy is the Knight of Swords in reverse, not telling someone what we think. Absolutely. Not bringing an idea to the table. We've had it. We've known it. This isn't something new this week. All right, Spirit. Got on my Aquarius hoodie today. So, rolling on. I started with Aquarius, did Pisces, now you Aries in this segment. Here we go. All right. Thank you, Spirit. The Page of Cups in reverse. Yes, absolutely not talking to someone about the way that we feel. Someone is not telling you how they feel. A younger person, a cousin, a child, a niece, a nephew. This could be Gemini, Libra. No. Yes. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Namely, a Gemini. So if you have a Gemini as a grandchild who did not message or is not telling you how they really feel about you. So if you've been wondering how they feel about you, the moon says, based on a foundation of a lot of time and a lot of things. So this is compiled for them, for you. This is what Spirit wants you to know, okay? The reason is these feelings, and this could be the reason that you are feeling this way in the moon. Somebody is feeling a certain type of a way with the Six of Pentacles. Which is about charity. It's about giving of our time. Feeling like I want to spend time with someone younger. I want to spend time with my grandchildren. I want to spend more time. Somebody like that didn't spend enough time with. I see somebody in that aspect as well. Again, the Seven of Pentacles. Because you can't get you can't get those days back. It's all these memories that we save up of all of these times and things. For you, Aries, and that's how Aries, these roots run deep for you. It means a lot. I do see someone here putting someone in their will. This is that type of energy, is someone who, you will do it. You desire to have the will to survive this. Somebody here, well, I be here long enough, have I done what I needed to do, has brought something, when I finally set, when this is finally set to rest, and it's about self-acceptance, and it's about somebody who is not feeling really a good way about things when it comes to love. because it always was about love. It wasn't about money. It was about mindset, feelings, love. And for somebody, you know, it's like when you see somebody's gravestone, you know, it'll say 1972 to 2052. And it's that dash in the middle. But I think that if this is Aries, so let me know down below if I've hit something that resonates for you folks, or any of you, any one of you in this. You might not be telling anybody this, but this is how you feel. A little uneasy with inside of yourself about the dash. You're caring about the dash because this isn't someone who's even worried about dying. Heck no. The Eight of Cups, but in reverse. When I go away, when I'm not here anymore, because I know that I have to go away eventually. I'm an Aries. I'm intelligent. I am. Not loving. And I'm not comfortable, and I'm not able to rest with what we've invested so far and up to this point, which is actually human, right? So if that resonates in the recent past, again, that was just all how big of a deal this is to you or to them or to all of you involved. Even for those of you who are dealing with these kind of people, the energy is affecting you in a beneficial way. This is a beneficial. So I feel that vibe, wanting to benefit, wanting everyone around you to benefit. Maybe just not feeling that it's been very beneficial. Have I been enough? Do they have enough to benefit? How is this going to benefit? Because when in the past, the King of Swords in reverse very much. You know, that's being a jerk. You know, jerky people. And then I hear something say, because they jerked around, you know, and you care what's going to happen. You know, have they saved up enough to retire on with the Seven of Pentacles and the Four of Swords? Have they saved up enough to take care of themselves? Because we don't know. We don't have. This is the Ace of Cups in reverse. We are we're not connected as much as we'd all like to be when it comes to matters of the heart and sharing and expressing our emotions and how we feel about this. Not willing to walk away. Something that we know when we do have to walk away, it is about when somebody takes that walk and leaves someone independent. Will they love themselves enough? Do they love themselves enough? Aries Spirit says this is that person who jerked around, who called you a jerk, is now no longer. Current influence, I'm doing this as a 10-card Celtic. This is the fifth card, the Queen of Swords. Look at this. The King and Queen, this close in a reading, is always a warning. And this would be, clash of mindset. They don't think like you, you don't think like them. But we are connected. We're family. We're partners in that type of a close of a connection. So in that, no longer being a bitch, this person is adulting very well in their mind. And so are you. And this is all you're doing in how much you care about how much they care about yourself. It means a lot to you on a personal level. What is going on with them on a personal level? They are adulting very well. And this person. bitch. This person is known for having a good side and a bad side. They are very mature. Yes, they are in their right mind. So are you. Feminine, negative energy. That was cool to see. That was good. Thanks, Spirit. So what's coming in, first future card, is time to celebrate. Four of Wands is coming together, birthday parties, holidays. Got all that coming up, which makes sense because July has come in. So happy Independence Day for my fellow Americans here in my hemisphere. And Four of Wands, first future card for Aries, is happy holidays. Congratulations on all graduations, celebrations, and unions, and all of that, okay? Looking good. So that's where you're at. You know that's where you're at. You're going to benefit. We've got 211. It's a fresh start. Celebrate that fresh start. How is Aries looking at themselves? Yeah, I mean, you're like still in a bubble. And, you know, the world is still going to continue to go on around you. But that's how you see yourself. Somewhat Four of Cups overprotective. Again, those feelings. I don't think you're ever going to really put that out on the table. How is other people seeing you? Well, they see you as having low self-esteem and the Five of Wands. So you are their mini-me, or you are, they are your mini-me. They're, you're not, you are not me, because this was in reverse. Okay, so that's like that agree to disagree energy. They know on a major arcana level, your level of strength. It does not make you look weak. That's why I got two cards. It makes you look like you, independent. We're all unique individuals. This is how any other energy around you is accepting Aries this month. That's nice. Thank you, Spirit. And let's see, what could get in the way of a good outcome? A lot of things could get in the way of a good outcome. And I'm not taking all of those, y'all. Come on, Spirit. Let's just go ahead and get like a couple. One would be nice. Anything that might get in the way of a good outcome. Because everything does look really good in this situation. Maintaining our ability to maintain a hope and faith in other people. You know, right? Because people are just stupid. We know that. Aries, I get it. You know what? If you maintain hope, you're going to manifest that, right? So just stay positive in mindset, and you will. Magician, look at this. Thank you, Spirit. Here we have Aries in general, being able to manifest anything you put your mind to. Anything you put your hands on is going to turn to gold for a while in manipulation in the physical realm. As long as you maintain hope and faith in humanity in any major event, you might have a little bit of self-doubt, okay? A lot of self-doubt. That's okay. Other people say, you know what? You may have doubted me, Aries. But that's okay because you're not me. And they respect that. And you know what? You keep yourself at a distance. You hold yourself like a genie in a bottle because that's what you are right now. I'm going to have title this Genie in a Bottle. You guys are going to manage to magician very well. Spirit. All right. But even that, like I said, you're going to benefit. And if that's them magicianing all around you, everyone having reason to celebrate with that Four of Wands coming in. And I was hoping to introduce you to one of my kitty cats. They showed up, Four Aquarius and then Pisces. But Aries, we were able to get, they're napping. I can see both of them. I should show them to you. But you'll get to see them soon. So check back. Good luck. And I will see you soon. Hit the like button. If you want to become a member, go ahead and subscribe. I'll see you soon. Have a good week. Bye.